Hey guys, Jake from 8020 Automotive here. Today we are talking about the P0507 engine fault code. A P0507 code will read idle air control system RPM higher than expected. Ultimately, what that means is that your car is idling at a higher RPM than it should be. In this video, I'm gonna go ahead and briefly talk to you guys about idle and how idle's controlled, since that is important for determining the causes and diagnosing a P0507 code. So first I'll go ahead and walk you through mechanical versus electronic throttle control. Then we'll go ahead and jump into the potential causes of a P0507 code, and I'll finish it off with a diagnostic list that you can go ahead and follow through to try to determine what's causing your P0507 code and how you can fix it. So idle speed or idle RPMs are controlled in two ways. We have the old school way, which is mechanical throttle control, and then we have the new way, which is electronic throttle control. This is important because there are different components to each types of this throttle control, and so depending on which one you have, the causes of this engine code might vary. So first, let's go ahead and talk about mechanical throttle control. In mechanically controlled cars, your gas pedal is actually attached to the throttle body via a cable linkage. So when you press down on the gas pedal, the linkage opens and it causes the throttle body or the butterfly valve to open up, and that lets air into the engine. But because the gas pedal is directly tied to the throttle body or the throttle valve, when your foot's not on the gas pedal, the throttle valve is completely closed off, and so there is no air getting through there. But of course, we need air for your engine to run, and we need air to idle. And so what cars with mechanical throttle control have is what's called an idle air control valve. And this idle air control valve basically bypasses the throttle body or the throttle valve and allows air in so that the engine can continue to idle even when your foot's not on the gas and the throttle valve is completely closed. The main thing here that I'll go ahead and get to is that we have an idle air control valve, which is a component that is not used on cars with electronic throttle control. On cars with electronic throttle control, there is no direct tie-in between the gas pedal and the throttle valve. Everything is done electronically. So we have a sensor that's on the accelerator pedal. It's called the accelerator pedal position sensor. And as you press that down, it then sends a reading to the throttle body actuator, which is a small motor located on the throttle body, which then opens up the throttle body via that motor. So with electronic throttle control, everything is done electronically via sensors, and there are a number of other sensors that are used, like your throttle position sensor, vehicle speed sensors, MAF or MAP sensors, so on and so forth. So when it comes to a P0507 error code, the most important thing to understand here is whether you have electronic or you have the old school mechanical throttle control. Primarily because one of the common causes on these older vehicles is issues with your idle air control valve. And if you go reading, you know, articles or watching other videos, they're like, clean your idle air control valve. But if you have a newer car, kind of mid-2000s onwards, there's a very strong chance you don't have an idle air control valve. So you might get a little bit confused on how to clean or check your idle air control valve when you don't have one. With that being said, let's go ahead and talk about causes of P0507 codes. And I'm going to go ahead and split this into two. For cars that have mechanical throttle control, and then for cars that have electronic throttle control. So for cars with mechanical throttle control, the common causes of P0507 codes are gonna be the idle air control valve. These things can get dirty or clogged up that'll cause them to not either open up fully or they won't close fully, and that can cause your idle to be higher than it should be. Two, we could have a dirty throttle body to where when your foot's fully off of the accelerator pedal, the throttle body's not closing completely, and so extra air is being let past through the valve inside the throttle body, and that's causing higher RPMs. Third, we could have vacuum leaks. Four, we could have issues with the PCV valve being stuck open or leaking. And then five, we could have issues with a number of sensors here as well. The most common ones being the throttle position sensor, your MAF or MAP sensor, vehicle speed sensor, or the idle switch sensor. So that's it for cars with mechanical throttle control. Now let's go ahead and talk about cars with electronic throttle control. The most common cause here is going to be a dirty throttle body that's either causing it, again, to not open or close fully via the actuator motor that controls it. Second, you're also going to have potential vacuum leaks. Third, also potential issues with your PCV valve being stuck open or stuck closed. And then fourth is going to be an issue with a number of sensors as well, which is similar to cars with mechanical control. You just now have a couple other sensors that could cause this problem, namely being the throttle body sensor and the accelerator pedal position sensor, in addition to all the other sensors that could affect mechanical cars as well, like your throttle position sensor, your MAF or MAP sensors, etc. So regardless of which throttle control mechanism you have, everything is still similar in that the throttle body, vacuum leaks, PCV valve issues, and sensor issues can cause problems with your RPMs at idle being higher than they should be. The main difference is that the idle air control valve is an extra component that you have to look into if you have mechanical throttle control. Now that we've gone ahead and broke down what things actually cause a P0507 engine code, let me walk you through how I would go about trying to diagnose what the issue is. First, I would go ahead and check for any other possible codes that your engine is throwing. If you have an issue with one of the sensors, it is very possible that you have a sensor failure, and that sensor failure is therefore then the cause of the P0507. So the P0507 could be secondary to a failure with one of the initial sensors, and because all of these sensors tend to have their own codes with them, if one of them has failed, you'll likely see an engine code for that sensor. So go ahead and check whatever other codes you have and look into those specific components, just since the P0507 could be being caused by something else. And checking that could help you lead directly to what that issue is. If you don't have any other codes, you're just getting the P0507 or the other codes lead you to a dead end. The second thing that I would do is go ahead and check and clean the throttle body. There are throttle body cleaners that are available at any auto parts store, and this will help to make sure you don't have any gunk or buildup that's causing the valve to not open or close properly. Third, I would check for vacuum leaks and check your PCV system. So go ahead and look at all of your vacuum lines. Make sure there's no leaks from the vacuum lines. Inspect the PCV system. Make sure there's no issues with the PCV system. And if we can eliminate any vacuum leaks or PCV related issues, then the only thing that's left is for mechanically controlled cars, and that's to check your idle air control valve and to go ahead and pull that off and clean that as well. So generally speaking, it's pretty simple. Let's look for codes. We're going to want to check for vacuum leaks and PCV related issues. And if it's not one of those, then it is going to probably be one of the main components like the throttle body or the idle air control valve. Anyways, guys, that wraps it up for a video on P0507 engine codes. I hope this was helpful in helping you determine what type of throttle control system you have, as well as where you should be looking to try to figure out what's causing this issue on your vehicle. If you guys appreciate this video, please click the like button, subscribe to our channel, and stay tuned for all the future diagnostic and engine code related videos we have coming.